Go to File, New Document. 8.5 by 11 is going to be fine for this tutorial. Go ahead and click OK. Alright, now we want to create a text box. Let's draw a text box over this whole page. And let's right click on the text box. And then we're going to select Text Frame Options, or Control B. And then we're going to change the number of columns up here to 2. Click OK. So this is going to be kind of like a magazine or newspaper style layout. In order to kind of see how it's going to look with text, let's go ahead and add some. If you right click on the text box, you want to go down to Fill with Placeholder Text. And now InDesign has just created some dummy text. It doesn't make any sense, it's just gibberish, but it'll work for this tutorial. So let's zoom out a little bit and kind of make it look like a magazine. We're gonna select this first letter with using the text tool, and under your paragraph options, let's increase this to a 2. Actually, let's increase that to a 3. So it has kind of a magazine look to it. Alright, now we've got our text box all taken care of. We're going to place in our picture. For this one, I'm going to be using a pair. You can go to File, Place, and you pretty much just want to select pretty much a picture with a white background, or something that's continuous, or something that has quite a bit of contrast between the object and the background. And that'll make it a little bit easier for InDesign to automatically detect it. If not, you can always do it manually. So let's go ahead and click on the pair, click OK, and let's just click somewhere to place it. So now we have our picture of the pair in there. Let's go ahead and make this a little bit bigger. You can type in the percentages right here, or you can actually just drag one of the edges while holding down Control and Shift at the same time. Let's do that right now. Alright, now we have our pair in there. Let's go ahead and do the magic. It's looking a little jaggedy right now. Let's go ahead and turn on Overprint Preview. And now you can kind of get an idea for what the picture looks like. Okay, this is the fun part. So what we want to do is go to Object, Clipping Path. With the picture selected, we're going to turn on Preview so we can actually see what each of these options does. We're going to click on Detect Edges, and as you can see, it just dropped out the background. Now there's a little bit of white on the edges here, because the InDesign pretty much finds everything that's different and goes from there. So if we want to actually get a better idea of what's going on here, we can zoom in on the pair here, and let's go back to Object, Clipping Path, Detect Edges, and now you can kind of see the white, just a sliver of white there. If we had a black background, it'd be really easy to see. But what you can do is you can change the threshold, and if you increase the threshold, it starts cutting out more and more of your picture. But what we want to do is just take a little bit more off. And decrease the tolerance. Actually, let's just keep it right there. Click OK. And we're going to zoom out. If you hold down Alt whenever you have the magnification tool selected, it'll change to a minus sign and we can zoom out. So here's our pair. If you want to see the points that the clipping path is drawn out, use the direct selection tool, click on the pair, and you can see exactly where all the paths are. And you can see this big area of white right here that it didn't take care of. All you gotta do, get a little bit closer to it, use the direct selection tool and just start moving points around until you get a final image that you're happy with. We can use this guy right here to what I do is put that out right there. Put in, and then use this guy right here. Okay, so now our stem's a little better. And you can do that on the whole entire object if it happens to be a little bit more complex, or if InDesign just did a poor job taking the background out. But this pair is in decent shape, so let's go ahead and go on to the next step. What we want to go do from here is use our text wrap. You can click text wrap over here, or if you don't have it selected, you can go to Window, Text Wrap. Now we have text wrap selected. Let's go ahead and click on Wrap Around Object. And you can see now the text is wrapping around this pair. We already have a pretty nice effect. We got the letter up there, we got the pair. We can resize the pair at this point if we want to make it a little bit bigger, a little bit more impact. Let's zoom out a little bit so you can kind of get a feel for it. Now let's do the last effect. Let's top it off with a drop shadow. Use the ellipse tool. Draw a little ellipse on the bottom here. And as far as the color, we're going to want to go to swatches. And the stroke, we want to be no stroke. And as far as the fill, let's have black around 50% tint. And now what we're going to do is we're going to use the feather tool on the object, feather, and let's click on preview so we can see what each one's doing. And right now I'm just clicking in here, and then I'm going to be pressing up and down in order to quickly see how much we need to add in order to get the desired effect. I think a quarter of an inch is good for this one. Let's click on OK. And what we're going to want to do is have the text also wrap around this right here. So let's go back to our text wrap. Click on the wrap around object. And now we got a pair hovering above a shadow. And if you want to, you can go ahead and use the direct selection tool, add points with the pin tool. Go to Add Anchor Point Tool and just click a bunch of points in here. We're going to kind of give it the effect of having a bite taken out of it. So what I'm doing is I'm just clicking a bunch of points right here. This is adding points. I'm going to go back to my direct selection tool and just start taking these points and moving them. So start dragging them in. You can just keep dragging them around until you get the desired effect. Doesn't need to be too terribly complex. We're just kind of showing how you can actually use the direct selection tool in order to modify your paths. You can add paths, you can create the clipping path from scratch, you can have InDesign do it for you. But what we're able to do here is we've created a bite out of it. Notice how the text has gone ahead and wrapped inside of the pair. We didn't have to do anything extra. We didn't have to move text around. Now notice if we had done this in, let's say, Photoshop, we would still have this big box right here, and the text would be wrapping around that box, not the object.